when I first saw Dateline on television, and I was working for the ABC on the 7:30 report, I remember saying, an international program with an Australian perspective, I want to work there. For me, it was a way of seeing history, being a witness to history. I can say to my children, and perhaps one day to my grandchildren, that I was there in the last days of the Cold War. I was there in East Berlin when the wall came down, seeing history change. I was there covering an election in India when Rajiv Gandhi was blown to bits. I was there covering the Bali bombings. So many events that changed history. And name another job in the world that could give you that sort of experience, the front row of history. Up to 1 million Tutsis and moderate Hutus were dead, slaughtered. Up to a million or two, I think, Hutus had escaped into what was then known as Zaire. I'll never forget that sight, driving in there and seeing a sea of people, black volcanic rock. There were people cooking, sleeping, defecating, dying, all next to each other. Mostly innocent Hutus who had to go. And I think it was about 30% of the people there were the killers, the militias, the Interahamwe army. They were still wearing military uniforms, some of the soldiers, and they were a defeated army, but they had all these people with them and they were able to hide. And they weren't helping. They were apparently still getting paid by the former Hutu government that cleared out the treasury. So here were people who couldn't go. They were captive. And it was just so sad to see these wretched people for month after month after month there, you know, being born and dying where they lived and ate and slept. The most difficult challenges, I think, were getting to the truth. I mean, those camps, you had people who were hiding behind poor, wretched men, women and children and babies. And you didn't know whether you were talking to a killer or a victim or someone who just wanted to go home and wasn't allowed to. Getting to the truth there is difficult.
This child was almost scalped. This one was thrown into a fire after his parents had been murdered. All revenge attacks on moderate Hutus by the former government thugs.
You just got on with it, you know. And when you're in a situation like that, you don't think. You don't think about your safety and you don't think about anything apart from, I'm here to do a job and I mustn't think too much about how dreadful this is. I've got to put down those emotional shutters to protect myself. Because if I start processing, my God, how did we get here? Another genocide? Didn't we learn from the last one? Well, you know, you'd go mad, you know, you'd be affected and you couldn't do your job. So you had to be totally professional. And I remember in one of the refugee camps, there was a little kid that was following me around. And at that point you think, oh, what can I give this child, you know? Can't give him a hug, I can't do anything. So seriously, this child was walking around and I just felt terrible, but I just ignored this child and just kept moving. I saw something like that in my lifetime and I never thought I would.